that's how I get that ooh.
And now back to your regularly scheduled program.
What's good to YouTube? How's everyone doing? Welcome to the channel, or welcome back to yet another live reaction video. If you're new here for the first time, my name is TMR, and since you clicked on this video, you might as well subscribe to the YouTube channel, leave your comments down below, and enjoy this reaction video. What's good to YouTube? What's good, TMR gang? Welcome back to the channel. And welcome back to yet another live reaction video. I'm your girl, TMR. Thank y'all so much for stopping what you were doing and meet me over in this damn break room, y'all. Oh, boy. All right, y'all. Y'all see the title, okay? Look, y'all, I really didn't have much to talk about. I just wanted to jump on here real quick. Because y'all, I've been looking at the internet and I just seen some couple things I wanted to discuss with y'all. What y'all doing? Happy Saturday to you all. Saturday evening now. Pretty Dope said, I'm sitting here applying for jobs. Well, sis, I pray that you get the job you are definitely looking for, honey. What y'all doing? Child. PJ said, girl, we love the sound of your voice. Oh, thank you so much, sis. I appreciate that. Hey, Buttons. Hey, T. Wilson. Reed Beans. What's good, sis? Iris. Hey, y'all. Yeah, this is a little late night live, y'all. You, Humble said, I'm relaxing, enjoying some kid-free time. I know that's right, sis. Hey, Kitchen Trap Queen. I'm making a banana pudding for a customer. Just got out the pool. It's hot in Arizona. I know that's right, sis. Miss Yvonne said, I'm laying in the bed, girl. I ain't doing nothing. Brooklyn Diva said, child, I'm on my third drink. He said, Tasha, you see Liv trying to throw subliminals about her baby daddies to make Nisha and Miss Donna feel some type of way. She a mess. No, I haven't. I didn't see that, Von Von. Oh, you packing for a vacation? Okay, well, sis, have a good time and be safe. You watching Tubi? Hey, her, how are you? You on a treadmill? No, Von, I didn't see that. I haven't been over to Olivia's channel. I think the last time I was over there, child, she was over there beefing with Olivia, or not Olivia, Lord, listen to me. She was over there beefing with Nisha about her mama popping off at Olivia because she was late picking up the kids. I'm feeling okay, sis. I'm on my phone, y'all. I'm not on my computer. I'm on my phone. I didn't feel like doing all that. I was just sitting here scrolling. Did y'all see? Let's talk about something a little different because I think a lot of you guys may know what's going on. Did y'all see Glorilla got arrested for DUI in Atlanta the other day? Child, shouts out to the Law and Crime Network YouTube channel. Hey, S. Wiseman, here our family. Child, she got pulled over in Atlanta the other day, and it was the craziest thing. You know, hey, Woo, hey, Audra, it's the craziest thing, honey. You know what? When I was watching the body cam footage of Glorilla getting pulled over, for the first thing that came to my mind was, Glow, sis, why are you driving yourself around? Now, I understand, you know, she's regular folk, but to me, y'all, celebrity status is not celebrity status anymore, right? Yeah, Reed Beans, y'all make sure y'all clock in. Hit the like button. Celebrity status to me is just not celebrity status anymore. It just makes it seem like, you know, it's just regular schmegler everyday people. You know what I mean? When you know, back in the day, celebrity stardust, it was almost like some type of elite echelon. You know, you were like the upper crest. But nowadays, it takes nothing for you to get quote unquote status because of social media. You can have one viral video, and you know, you popping. It doesn't really take much effort, in my opinion, to be what they quote unquote be a celebrity. And when I saw that she had got pulled over and I listened to the footage, first and foremost, you know, y'all know Glorilla from Glorilla is from Memphis. And you could definitely tell, okay, honey, that country twang in her voice. And she was basically telling the cop that she was coming back from a hosting. I guess she was hosting an event or, you know, a show or something. And she had a passenger in the car. So apparently she was on her way home. Hey, LaToy. I miss when the celebs were exclusive. Yeah, that's true, Black and Bougie. I do too, honey. So apparently she was on her way home and she was hungry and they was going to stop at the Waffle House. And I guess from what she says, the GPS took her the wrong way. So she did a U-turn and, right, you know, the police saw her and pulled her over. Now, the police said once they approached the car, it was a female officer, said that they smelled, you know, marijuana in the car. Obvious. And that, you know, she was asking Glorilla, was she intoxicated? How much did she have to drink? So Glo was like, I'm straight. And she was like, that ain't what I asked you. You know, how much did you have to drink? She was like, I'm straight. I'm good. You know, so needless to say, she asked for her ID. She gave the cop her ID. She asked, and so as the officer and Glorilla was doing this exchange, while Glorilla sitting in the driver's seat and the officer standing at the driver's side window, and Glorilla says to her, you don't know who I am? And baby, I thought that was so funny because was she supposed to know who you was, Glorilla? Like, I get it, sis. But really, did she really? Because based off your ID, it wasn't giving her Glorilla, who's collab with Cardi B and several others. It was just like whatever her real name is. I can't remember what her real name is. But I like how Glorilla didn't get indignant. She wasn't smart and sassy. And, you know, she basically let the cop do her job. The officer asked her, was there any weapons in the car? And she said, yes. And they're registered to me. And so she ended up having, the officer really felt like Glorilla was intoxicated. So she was like, you know what? I need you to do some field sobriety tests. And so Glorilla was like, for what? You know, she said, because, you know, I feel like you're under the influence and I just need you to do these sobriety tests. So Glorilla gets out the car. And now, mind you, the passenger in the car the whole time, later on in the conversation, I believe Glorilla said that that was her brother. Because when she realized, because Glorilla ended up getting arrested, when she realized she was getting arrested, she asked if she could give her jewelry to her brother. So, as she was doing that, and she did like three sobriety tests, and I ain't gonna lie, y'all, Glorilla passed all of them with ease. She didn't have no issues with it. But the officer just really felt like she wanted to take her to jail. So then she suggested, she asked her, would she take a sobriety, you know, the breathalyzer, and Glorilla refused to do it. And she was like, but I passed all these three tests. Why I got to take a breathalyzer? So needless to say, because she refused, they went on and took her to jail. But the funny part about it is, and in the midst of the whole sobriety test, child, Glorilla's titty popped out of her shirt, and the officer was like, you're a little exposed over there, and she covered her up. I thought that was hilarious. And then what I also thought was funny was Glorilla kept talking about how she had to pee and she was about to pee on herself. She asked the officer, could she, you know, go over there, squat by her vehicle, you know, pull her panties down and pants down and pee real quick. Officer said no. Glorilla also had told her, like, her pants was, like, unzipped, because I guess at some point Glorilla did, you know, pull her pants down and peed in the middle of the road somewhere, and when she jumped back in the car, or maybe she was getting ready to pee when the officer pulled her over, so she kind of unzipped and unbuttoned her pants, so when she get out the car, she could hurry up and pee. Baby, it was a mess. It was a mess, honey. I said, girl, no, you didn't have to pee-pee. I said, Glorilla, your mama didn't teach you to pee before you leave the building? Child, hilarious. Glorilla also told the officer that She had peed a little bit on her hand. So I guess at some point, Glorilla did attempt to try to like pull over and pee. And when she was, you know, pulling her pants down, squatting in the middle of the road, she got a little pee-pee on her hands. Child, it was a whole entire mess. But needless to say, she ended up going to jail. Yes, her name is Glorilla. Gloria, excuse me, Gloria Hallelujah. And then you also found out that Glorilla lives in Duluth. I said, maybe Long Cry Network just doxed Glorilla's whole whereabouts. So you found out, I said, girl, no, you don't live up the damn street. So she lives in Duluth. But the biggest thing for me was, I was just curious of why she didn't have a driver, especially that late at night. You've been drinking, you intoxicated, you high. Says, why you just didn't have a driver? So if anybody would have got pulled over, we would just hope and pray that the driver that you know, paid to drive you would be legit. And, you know what I'm saying? You could have went on about your business. You could have, you know, went to the Waffle House, peed on the side of the road. You could have did all that sis and still made it home without getting arrested. She was smiling all in her mugshot. She sure was. Because she knew she was going to get right out. Because she said it. She said, well, I'm going to get right out. She said, I just need to make a phone call. I said, girl, I know that's right. You said Duluth is a little hood, but they have some really beautiful homes. Yes, they do. Now, Duluth didn't used to be the hood. Duluth used to be really, really nice. I guess over the years, it didn't get hoodified. But Duluth used to be real nice. Let me see. She was. Okay, I read that. I like glow to a degree, but celebs aren't my thing because they contribute to the debauchery of black culture. Yeah, and you know, and segueing into that. So apparently now, well, I guess it's been going on for a while. I'm like you, Black and Bougie. I don't really keep up with the celebrities. The reason why I know about it, because I'm on social media and I'll go peek on Instagram and I'll go peek on the Shade Room and Hollywood Unlocked and places like that. And I'll kind of see what's going on. But apparently, Quavo and Chris Brown is beefing. I guess apparently back in the day, a few years ago, I'm going to just say a few years ago, not back in the day, but a few years ago, Chris Brown apparently slept with Sweetie, because y'all know Quavo and Sweetie were going together. Y'all know, remember the infamous elevator video when they was fighting over the video game in the elevator, Quavo and Sweetie. And all I was thinking was, okay, so now Quavo and Chris Brown beefing, Drake versus everybody, Rick Ross threw his old ass hat in the ring. I said, child, even Taylor Swift beefing with Kim Kardashian. I said, what is wrong with you people? Y'all ain't got nothing else better to do. Again, I guess what I'm trying to get to is, aren't y'all celebrities? Like, this what y'all do? And then they wonder why people don't respect their privacy. They wonder why people don't respect them as being quote unquote celebrities. Look what the type of stuff y'all do on the internet. You said that's a whole mess with Drake against everyone. Yes, you know what, y'all? I've been so off of Drake. Child, I ain't bopped to a Drake song since Kiki, Are You Riding? Boom, boom, boom. I don't pay no attention to them people anymore. I feel like music in a whole is so played out. Music is nowhere near like it used to be. You know, way, way years ago, you could come up with a hit song and people will be bopping and, you know, vibing to your song. The radio station's playing your song. But just because you came up with one hit song don't mean you're famous. Like it took you going to do shows and it took the radio, different radio station to keep playing your music. Like back then, artists really put in the work to be where they are now. Like, and I'm going to go real far back, like a Smokey Robinson and Lionel Richie and, you know, and the names go on. Like those cats really put in the work to be where they are today. But now all you got to do is say something really catchy. You can sing like two bars and somebody do a TikTok dance and boom. You, now all of a sudden you consider the celebrity. Like people don't put in the work anymore. And I just realized music just isn't music anymore. It's a mess. Yeah, it is crazy, LaToy. You said Chris tore Quavo up with that lyric saying everyone wished it was him instead of Takeoff passing away. Chris mean, LOL. Yeah, that was kind of low down what he said. But I'm like, all this over sweetie? I think what it is, I can't remember her name. It's something Karush, some woman that Chris Brown used to date. I guess apparently Quavo is tiptoeing in the toodles with the woman and Chris Brown in his feelings. I said, all this over a chick. Y'all worse than the women. You said wealth trumps fame any day. F that. Our family, our journey says, I promise. I don't know about none of that beef. I'm here for the talent, not their beef. They all get on my nerves with the beef. Y'all all have money. Go your mutual career corners and live your best life. But that's the problem, Carusha. Thank you, sis. Carusha Tran. Thank you, sis. Again, y'all, I'm sorry. When it comes to celebrity, like, I don't really get into these people. Carusha Tran, I don't even know who that is. I have never even, maybe I've heard of her, just didn't really pay no attention. I don't know, y'all. It's just weird. It's just weird how these people carry on. And I don't have, especially with all this stuff that's coming out with Diddy. And, you know, it just makes you feel like y'all did all this to get to the point now where you about to lose everything. Imagine being Diddy. You did all you did to get to the point where you are now, as far as, you know, being a music producer, you know, fashion designer, and all the other accomplishments you apparently made throughout the years. You did all of that to get to today's current point. It's like, how stupid can you be? Imagine being worth all that money and throwing it away because you made poor decisions, because you were so rich and felt so powerful that you were, you know, above the law, and you could treat people any old kind of way because, you know, money make you do strange things, right? And obviously Diddy is a prime testimony of that. It's just real disgusting to me how these people carry on. Us regular folk got more cool. And that's true, sis. You said she's beautiful. She's Asian and Black. She was on that TV show with Niecy Nash. Okay, I never watched that. Hey, Ambrosia. I know how to spell her name. Sean Smith. Thank you, Sean. Yeah, so I don't know, y'all. TMR, she was on Claws. See, I never watched that, lovely Shanika. I haven't watched reality TV. Like, sit down and actually watch reality TV in a minute, okay? It's been a minute since I watched reality TV. I think the last time I really got into reality TV was the whole Ghost series. When Ghost was out, that's when Power, I'm calling it Ghost. When Power was, which Power, you know, is still going on, but once they killed Ghost and all that other stuff was going on, baby, I fell off. Let me see. You said I grew out of that guy. Yeah, like Loving Hip Hop Atlanta. I remember the time I would miss. Loving Hip Hop used to come on Mondays, I think it was. Baby, I wouldn't miss a Monday. I remember a time where Real Housewives of Atlanta. But I guess the more people started being on the internet, vlogging their lives, or, you know, TikTok became, you know, very well used, and people started, you know, widely using YouTube. It kind of pushed, in my opinion, kind of pushed people off of reality TV. And they just come to the internet and see it for free, basically. Yeah, Von, after Ghost died, I kind of checked out. So, I don't know, y'all. When I think about the future, 10 years from now, like Hollywood is we all know Hollywood is now Hollyweird. And I think in my mind, Hollywood has died. Girl, I can't even tell you the last time. I don't even know what the latest movie that's just came out. Like, we're so caught up in all the salacious things that Diddy got coming out and everybody that's suing him. We're so caught up in that, child. What Has Warner Brothers or Paramount, have they came out with a movie lately? Like, I don't even know what's going on at the theaters. Because, baby, I'm so busy checking the shade room every day to see what the new tea is. You said, I haven't watched reality TV in years. I don't know the most. Yeah, I clocked out on reality TV probably like about 2019, 2020. I haven't been into it for a very long time. Hollywood isn't true talent anymore. Just a bunch of social media people without professional training. Exactly, sis. And it just makes you, hey, Jen Jones, it just makes you feel like, you know how, I remember when I graduated high school and there were people in my graduating class that were going to school to become an actor or actress. I remember that. Do people still do that? You know what I'm saying? Like, nowadays, you really don't have to do that. All you have to do is go viral on TikTok, just like Risa Tisa. Risa Tisa been signed on with a talent agency. She's now doing a collab with Hyundai. Is it Hyundai? Hyundai? The Palisade. She just got a new Palisade. They gifted her that. Like, and all this lady did was got on social media and did a 51-part series about this guy she met back during the pandemic and was married to him for about a year, a little over a year. And this woman has basically got celebrity status. And all she did was, for about 6 days, put out a total of 51 parts of some videos. And that's all she had to do. She didn't have to take out a college loan. She didn't have to apply for a Juilliard school. She didn't have to do any of that. You know, not saying that's the only way you should be able to become an actor or actress or have talent, because we know there's plenty of people with talent that never make it to places like that, you know. That, you know, they say that a lot. They say it's the people in prison, men and women. It's a bunch of talent of men and women that's locked up in prison. But unfortunately, that, you know, they got into some criminal activity and their, you know, the talent was, it went useless. But no more acting classes. The drama performing arts degree is trash now. Yeah, it definitely, I would think it would be, because I mean, think about it, performing arts. You don't have to. All you got to do is go viral. I mean, look at Peach McIntyre. Look what she did. She's a whole hot mess. And that woman has went viral a couple times on social media. And child, she, I don't, hell, did she even go to, hell, did Peach got a high school diploma? Child, a mess. Just a pure mess. Remember Prison Bay? He's a Tubi star. Oh, Prison Bay. You talk about the one with that his mugshot went viral because he had them real pretty eyes. I think he was, what was he from, California? Is that who you talking about, Black and Bougie? Now he not a Tubi star. Well, okay. Yeah, Jen Jones, it's so true. Tasha, did you see the short I sent you of her? Can we watch it together? Of her, who, Olivia? No, sis, we can't because I'm on my cell phone. I'm not on my computer, so unfortunately we can't. I'll go live tomorrow. I think you're talking about Olivia when Olivia had her leg stretched up in the air.
I mean, yeah.
He's a model too. Yes, him. Okay, didn't he get married to some white lady and then they got divorced or something? I don't know, y'all. I'm sorry, y'all. I'll see things and I'll hear things, but I don't really, you know. Yeah, she had her legs up in the air or something. She said that she's still real flexible. Olivia then took 5 injections, and girl, you would think she went from 300 pounds to 30 pounds. Girl, she done took about 6 injections, and you would thought she had lost 200 pounds in 2 days. Liv need to cut it out. Nobody's circling back for her. Oh, yeah. Is Peach the creator of Living in the Projects? I watched a couple of them, and they're always shouting out shouting out Peach, Living in the Projects. I've never seen that rapping, BK. Is that here on YouTube or is that on TikTok? Yeah, I seen that, Vine. Peach did that a couple years ago. Now she looking like a bag of Kroger cereal, girl. You are a mess. You are a mess. I see Jasmine being quiet over there, y'all. So after Jasmine came on here, checking her credit karma, trying to see if somebody would, you know, loan her $5,000 to $10,000 so she can get a credit right so she can move. I guess nobody bit, and she ain't been on here for a couple days. Just a mess, honey. She's on that Moderna. And her latest video, she filters herself to make it seem as if she's skinny and trying to look like Kim Kardashian. Who, Olivia? It's okay. Thank you, Reppin. Baby, she's going to have to do more than six injections of Moderna to look like Kim Kardashian. Child, no shit. Baby, these people tickle me. She said, do you think she's a Sam's Club bag? Child, that's a mess. I did see Olivia did a live. I think I saw that today. I think the live was maybe like 15 minutes where she was talking about Gerard called her so she could speak to the kids. But she couldn't answer the phone because, child, she was out door dashing. So she told, I guess that's what she told her. Maybe she texted him that because y'all know they talk on that app. And she said she'll, you know, we'll call him back. She was, you know, door dashing so she can, you know, give him his child support he so desperately needs. And so she said when she went back to call him back, she couldn't talk to the kids because they weren't with him or something to that effect. So she was feeling some type of way because she can't never talk to her kids when she wants to talk to them. And when I heard her say that, I'm like, well, sis, you had the opportunity to talk to him. That's the whole reason why Gerard called you, because he had all the kids. You were the one that was busy. So at your allotted time, you weren't available. So Gerard went on to do what he had to do with the rest of his day. So I don't understand what you're mad about. You should have put the door dashing on hold since it's very important to you to speak to your children. You should have put the door dashing on hold and spoke to your children. I mean, how long is the phone calls? 15, 20, 30 minutes? And then after you finish chatting, like really, sis, how much of a conversation are you going to have with the kids? What you guys do in school today? What you're eating? What you're doing? Like 15, 20 minute conversation. And then you could have went on back to door dashing. Yeah, all she had to do was pause the app. Like, I don't understand what the big deal is. It's not like Gerard don't let you talk to him. When he had called you for your scheduled time, you weren't available. So he proceeded to go on with his day. So he's supposed to just hold still until you're able. Like, how was he supposed to know what time you were going to be available to talk? You didn't tell him, hey, I'll call you back in an hour. I'll call you back in two. Or Gerard, can I call you back in an hour? Is that okay? You based off what she said in that live, you didn't say that. So how was Gerard supposed to know when you were supposed to be free? He went on with the rest of his day. And then once you were free, you called. Everybody was busy with the rest, you know, doing whatever they do in the evening. And so she gave, baby, I don't know. It's a mess over there. I'm just really sick of Olivia. Always coming to the internet to vent about her situation with her and Gerard as if that's going to make it any better. It actually makes it worse. Like, if she ever wants to co-parent with Gerard, sis, you probably should stop putting your business when it comes to you, him, and those kids on the internet. Regardless of what anybody else is doing, you, the mother, needs to stop doing it because Gerard has to deal with you. Because you're the mother of those children. I don't understand why she don't understand that. Like, if you ever want to get to the point where your situation will be better with him, Stop doing the things that over time he has decided to despise you about. How you always run into the internet putting out your business. Like, he was with it back then, but he's in a different space now, sis. He thinks it's kind of tacky. And let's be honest, it is. Liv never remembers her shit. Remembers the kids would call her and she would don't answer on her designated days. That's true. Well, not only that, Olivia did mention this. She said that she never did that to Gerard, and then she changed her story up. She said, well, in the beginning, when we first broke up, I did, girl, you called the police and told them people that that man was kidnapping his kids. When he came to Florida to pick his kids up, because you were mad because he wouldn't take you out to eat so you, him, and the kids can talk about your situation. You called the police and said that man kidnapped his kids. The police that had that man hemmed up and everything. Gerard ain't even from Florida. He's from Texas. As many of those Amber Alerts that they got out there, they probably thought this was a real Amber Alert. And you know what I'm saying? Like, that could have went all the way left. Like, sis, you did that. Now, obviously, that happened a few years ago. But it's the fact that you did it. Gerard ain't never called the police on you and said you was kidnapping the kids. Like, she don't be understanding. Olivia feels like because she did it so long ago, it doesn't count. It does count, sis. It's a part of your history. And until you prove that that's not you anymore, your people gonna still hold you to that. And in my opinion, the reason why she can't prove that that's not her anymore, because you keep running to the internet, running your business, sis. Like, be quiet. I don't know. She wants that old thing back. And you know what? He had to hire a private PI. Yeah, he did, Black and Bougie. And you know what? As much as Olivia may want the life that Gerard is living now with Antonisha, since too much has happened between you and that man. See, Olivia can look beyond that because she's a toxic person. So she doesn't mind all the toxicity her and Gerard has been through because she thrives in toxicity. So she's like, oh, well, you know, it's okay. Yeah, I told the internet he was gay. Yeah, I did put out a video where Gerard was soliciting a prostitute and I recorded our conversation. Yeah, I did do all that. But that's okay. It's in the past. It's like, no, sis. Yes, you're right. It is in the past, but so much has happened to you all. Not only that, girl, you didn't went and had two more kids by two different men. Like, really, sis, what that man supposed to do with you now? Because if Gerard wanted more children, he would have went and got that vasectomy reversed and would have put a baby up in Antonisha. He ain't done that yet. So you want this man to take on two more kids that don't belong to him and he don't even know who these men. I'm just saying, let's just say if Gerard did want to get back with Olivia, so now he got to deal with you and two other men. Again, I don't know if Olivia has relationships with these men, because we speculate Zolo is one of them, but we don't know who Kaylani's dad is. What makes you think Gerard gonna want to deal with two other men when he's always just dealt with you? At least the situation with Antonisha, he don't have any kids with Antonisha. So say, for instance, him and Antonisha break up and you and him got back together. Yeah, you don't have to deal with Antonisha because he don't got no kids with her. But in your situation, he got to deal with two other men. And who's to say how that's going to turn out? Like, sis, your life has changed drastically or dramatically because you've added two more children to your roster with two more men. So not only does Gerard have, you know, he would have to deal with two other men's children. Yeah, I don't think that man, even if that man wanted to get back with you, every time he think about the fact that you had two more kids by two different men, it probably stops some thoughts for him every time. Hey, PRB. You said Tasha, Liv, and Jasmine are on the prowl to try to destroy their baby daddy's new relationships because they are lonely. It's very sad. Well, Olivia's always been trying to destroy the relationship. I think Jasmine is just now gearing up because, you know, when Jasmine was with Chris, she didn't even whisper Phillip's name. Now that her and Chris is not together anymore, she damn near wears t-shirts saying, I'm Phillip's baby mama. She was going with the together. Hey, truth be told, you said 1, 2, 3 by 5. You so silly. She probably could have had a chance if she hadn't had 2 kids. You right, Tamar. Armani. I don't know. Yeah, again, I don't know Gerard. I don't know Gerard's temperament. I just know of Gerard because of the internet. I don't know. I know Gerard loves his kids. And the fact that he is responsible for them now, I don't know if him and Olivia would get back together. I just don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I think if Gerard and Antonisha didn't work out, I don't think he would double back with Olivia. I just really don't. I think Gerard has really moved past Olivia. And that's just my opinion. I could be wrong. But I don't think he would double back with her. I just don't think so. Black and Bougie, you agree too? Yeah. LaToya says, facts. Hey, Casey Harris. Ambrosia says, she evil AF, honey. You said you don't think she would have a chance in hell, PRB? Our family says, I think Gerard is over her. She has done way too much to that man and their kids. She can't come back from that. Yeah, I agree with you, our family, our journey. I believe Olivia is definitely at the point of no return. And I think she knows that too. But we all know Olivia is a sore loser, you know. So I don't know, y'all. He's outgrown Olivia. Yeah, I agree too, Tamreed. I believe he's had a taste of a different type of woman. And I think Gerard, if him and Antonisha didn't work out, Gerard wouldn't go back to Olivia. He would just move on to the next one. You know, he definitely wouldn't go back with Olivia. I'm willing to put money on that. I just don't think so. And it has nothing to do with that. I don't like Olivia. I don't care about Olivia enough to like her or dislike her. She's just a person on social media to me. I feel though, just based off the things I have seen, you know what I'm saying? And I guess I would put myself in Gerard's shoes. I wouldn't want to go back to Olivia after all that's went on with the internet. It would be a different story if all this didn't play out on the internet. Maybe they could, you know, work things out after, you know, extensive counseling and stuff. But it's the fact that this stuff is forever on the internet and it can never be erased. I don't think Gerard would go back that way. Like you guys all have said, and I definitely agree. I believe Gerard has grown from Olivia, and she knows that. You know, once upon a time, you know, Olivia literally had Gerard in the palm of her hand. Like, this man was on the social media, digging in between Olivia's butt cheeks, looking for hemorrhoids. Now, honey, you got to know a man love you when he will let you film him digging in between your tail looking for hemorrhoids and know that you about to upload this to social media. Baby, that you back then, oh, Gerard loved her. But that the Gerard then that was digging in her anus is not the Gerard today. Okay? He just not. I don't think she loves Gerard. I think Olivia wants to be taken care of. And she knows Gerard can do that. And why not be with the man that's the father of her 3 oldest kids? If anybody can do it, if she was to be with anybody, she would pick him because she's already has established a relationship with him, you know, from having, you know, being with him for 8, 9 years and having 3 kids with him. But I don't believe Olivia loves him. Olivia wants the life that he's living with Antonisha. I think Olivia feels like she deserves that because she was in the trenches with him when he didn't have anything. Now that he got a little something, she's been pushed to the side. And I believe Olivia feels like a return at Walmart. You know how you buy something from Walmart and you realize, Yeah, I've worn it a couple of times, but I don't really like it. And you return it back to the store? Yeah, I think that's what Olivia feel like. She feel like a return that's going back to Walmart. If she wasn't on YouTube, they would still be together. You think so, Armani? Well, let's do a little something for the people that catch this in the replay. You guys, if you watch Liv's Life and you're catching this in the replay, at this moment, put it in the comments. If you believe Armani, that what Armani said, if she wasn't on YouTube, I'm going to put that up here so people can see. If she wasn't on YouTube, they would still be together. If you believe that, put a one. If you don't believe that, put a two. He has upgraded his life in so many ways. Yes, he has, Nina. I remember when Gerard and Olivia were living with the Webs and they got excited because they got a washer and dryer. They was excited because they got a washer and dryer, you know, and there's nothing wrong with that because their financial situation back then, 5 years ago. Yeah, they were excited about stuff like that. But Gerard has surpassed that part of his life. And Olivia is still there. Child, she door dashing. And again, nothing against door dashing, right? But what I'm saying is, Olivia could sit on a live stream and in 1 hour make the money that she would, it would probably take her 4 hours to do riding around the streets of Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas. Two, she was a 304. No, it looks like he grew up and she's still in kindergarten. Yeah, I believe Jackie. I believe that. Not two to the two. PRB, you a mess. It's not two to the two power, hun. Two to the second power. I said two to the two power. Why is it so hard for people to think that man can move on? That men can move on. You know what? I don't, Black and Bougie, I don't think people think that men cannot move on. Hell, men move on. Shit, to be quite honest with you, I feel like men move quicker than the women do, especially when there's kids involved. Yes, PRB said, honey, two to the second power. She was like, PRB said, hell no. You said she is too lazy. And I think that's it too. I think Gerard wants a woman. And I don't want to say this. I don't want to say, okay, I think Gerard would want a woman that can match his energy, right? Olivia can't match his energy. She's too childish. She's too immature. You know, Antonisha, she's a professional woman. She has a, you know, a professional job. And, you know, and again, I'm not saying that you can't be on social media and not be professional because we see it. I just told you guys the other day, Peyton Marie Charles, who does social media for a living, just got a pre-approval to buy a home for $1 million pre-approval to buy a home, right? And she did that, all of that just being on social media. But obviously, Peyton Marie Charles, am I saying her name right? I believe so. Anyway, Peyton Charles, she's in a different situation. She's in a different mindset, different social status, just different all the way around. She will be keeping up drama with his family. I don't believe that we'll be all together. Well, not only that, Shan, a lot of Gerard's family does not like Olivia. And I mean, can you blame him? Look how she has talked about the people like a dog on this internet. And let's be honest, all of Gerard's family hasn't drugged Olivia on the internet, but Olivia has drugged a lot of them on the internet. Rod's family never liked Olivia. She mad because his family loves Nisha and accepts her. Black and Bougie said, that's why people divorce. I left my husband because he couldn't keep up with me. Single or not, I'll never choose him again because we don't match. Exactly. Right, Ambrosia, that's true, sis. So, you know, I don't know. So, y'all, we're going to get off Olivia because Olivia is like a science project. You can recreate it over and over and over, but there's always going to be something missing. Okay? Hey, Sunrise. You believe so, Armani? I think so too. I agree with you. I definitely agree with that. You said Peyton had been on YouTube for almost 10 years and has suppressed Jasmine by a long shot. Peyton's been on YouTube for 10 years? I thought she had started YouTube around the pandemic, or is that when she got serious about it? Our family said he has been introduced to better all around. He's not going back to someone like Lib after seeing that the world is bigger than that apartment. Some people don't have sense enough to have a good mate. Yeah, and that's true. Our family, our journey, like, you know, Olivia's over there furnishing her whole entire house with Goodwill finds, and Gerard's, you know, taking trips to Mexico and Jamaica. And here's the thing, Olivia could have been doing the same thing too, but she chose to take a different route, you know? The same way Gerard is living, Olivia had the opportunity to live the same way. Like, she got the opportunity. She had the opportunity. Olivia one time was making really good money on this internet. But she, you know, Gerard left her and she fell apart. Her oldest video is 9 years ago. Okay. Yeah, you know, a lot of, you know, I guess a lot of people got those videos on YouTube, but I believe she started taking YouTube more seriously when the pandemic hit, because that's when she lost her job. I remember Peyton talking about that when she hit 100K. So although she may have a video from 9 years ago, I believe she started doing YouTube, took it more seriously around 2020 when the pandemic hit. Gerard is not an angel. Yeah. You're right, Armani. Yes, you're right. Gerard is not an angel. Like, we're not wearing t-shirts with Jay Webb on the back over here. Okay. Yeah, we're definitely not doing, like, Gerard definitely has his faults. Okay. He has many of them. You know, here's the thing. Gerard and Olivia both led each other on in negative ways, right? When Olivia left Gerard and moved to Florida the first time, and then Gerard ended up doing what he was doing, and Olivia was doing what she was doing. Gerard at one point was just like Olivia. He didn't want to see her with nobody else. So he wanted to make the relationship work because obviously he wanted to be with his kids. And I think at that point, back then, he still had some love for Olivia. But I feel like they both played with each other. And obviously, when you know, you play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. You said, but to your mind, Gerard wouldn't be the person he is now, taking trips and glowing up because Olivia was his downfall. She kept him at a level basic. You know, PRB, I agree with you to a certain extent. There is a saying where people can, you know, people can bring you down or drag you down. But I believe at that point, Gerard wasn't really making money to make the money he's making now. Within the last few years, he started making the money that he's making now. And I believe, and this just is my belief, I don't know this to be certain, right? I believe if Gerard and Olivia would have stayed together, they possibly could have had a better life, but Olivia would have had to leave YouTube alone. And if she would have continued to do YouTube, she would have had to change the trajectory of her channel. Putting out, every time they got into an argument, she doing a YouTube video about it and throwing it on the internet, putting all their business out here for content, it wasn't going to continue to work for Gerard. Because I think once Gerard really realized, you know, I'm a family man. I got these, you know, I got this woman. I got my kids in my custody. I think that grew him up. I think it really did. I think it made him mature more. Just my opinion. I just don't like how Olivia gets on here and trash talks about the whole situation as if that makes it better. Because Olivia has been talking about this situation with her and Gerard. And again, she's right. She can talk about it because it's her situation. However, she's talked about it for years, what, 3-4 years, and it hasn't gotten any better for her. She still has not got to the point where she could co-parent with Gerard effectively. And for some reason, she feels like it's Antonisha is the reason. No, sis, you're the reason.
Liv kept him down just like Chris kept Jasmine in the gutter where he found her. You know, I'm gonna say this about Chris and Jasmine.
I think with Chris and Jasmine, at first, Chris was halfway kind of digging Jasmine because Jasmine was enticing him with her YouTube coin, right? But once that man really got in deep with her and the whole YouTube thing, and he seen how overly disrespected that she is on the internet, I believe Chris was like, this ain't worth it. Like, it ain't even enough money for me. I don't think Chris makes nowhere near the money that Jasmine at one point was making at whatever job he's at. But the one thing that man has now that he didn't have with Jasmine is his peace and his privacy. I don't know. That's just my opinion. You know, Jasmine is, she's hard-headed. I've told you guys that many times. And the biggest thing with Jasmine is, she's not a good mother. I don't care what nobody say. Anytime we can watch her videos, and when I say we, I mean the people, watches her videos, and it's been more than one person that has clearly noticed how she makes a grave difference between Legend and those other four. And even before Legend came into the picture, you can tell that Jasmine didn't embrace being a mom. Her kids would always seem like they're a burden to her. If you guys was watching when the twins were little versus how she treats Legend now, she treats Legend like Legend can do anything. He can scream, he can holler, he can punch her in the face, and she don't say nothing. The twins would be wet and hungry, and Jasmine would shut the door and allow those kids to scream to the top of their lungs. If y'all notice, the only time you hear Legend screaming is when he wants something that he can't have. Have y'all ever seen in the almost 3 years that little boy's been on this earth and y'all have been watching her videos, have y'all ever seen Legend locked up in a room with the door closed and Jasmine watching him from a security camera from the living room? Y'all have never seen that. And that's why until Jasmine do right by her children, no man is going to do right by her. Yep, that's true. Our family, our journey. Hey, that damn EB. She would punish those kids for asking for food because she felt like I gave y'all some noodles, a little small portion of noodles and some water and y'all fine. Not understanding that they were growing children. And, you know, when kids are little, y'all know that's all they want to do is eat because shit, they growing. But why have so many kids? Because she acts like they are not hers. Well, the reason why she had those kids because she was the man that she was with. In Jasmine's mind, she feel like kids make the man stay. If y'all notice, if you go back, every time Philip would get another chick pregnant, she would come up pregnant. And that's the whole reason why she had Legend. Again, y'all, this is my opinion. That's the whole reason why she had Legend, to keep Chris, to make Chris feel like, oh, we a whole family. Although she had four kids when she met him, but them four kids wasn't Chris. She had to have a baby with Chris to make her feel like her and Chris was a family. Hey, Miss Ali.
Right, Ambrosia, that's true. You said now with Stankerbug, I don't know. She definitely had that baby to keep Chris. Now she's stuck with him. Regret it. Now she's stuck with him. I don't think she regrets. I think Jasmine is still holding up out light that Chris will change his mind and come back. She did the same thing with Philip, y'all. Although Philip had two kids that we know of, because y'all know Asia, Philip, one of Philip's baby mama, she used to be a mod for my channel. Philip had two kids with her. Jasmine was still holding on for hope that Philip would just love her and her only. The only reason Jasmine let go, because she was forced to let go, because Philip went to prison. Had Philip never went to prison, Chris would have never been able to intercept Jasmine. Because that's, she was very dedicated and loyal to Philip. And I think now that Chris is no longer in the picture, I think Jasmine now is starting to resent Philip more for not, again, this is just my opinion, starting to resent Philip more because she sees what he's doing over there with Hannah, who has no children, and she got the foe, and she can't get no respect out of him. But that's the thing, sis, you never could get the respect, even before Hannah came into the picture. Yeah, LaToy. KP Coco said it's been a few years, crazy that they still can't co-parent. Are you talking about Olivia and Gerard? He was never fond of the Davis Four, no matter how hard he tried to pretend. I think the only kids that Chris was fond of was his twin boys. And that's because LaKenya, who's the mother of his twin boys, his oldest children, he dated her in high school. So he kind of grew up with LaKenya. So he, those twin boys kind of hold a special place in his heart. Because I think out of all the women Chris has children with, LaKenya is the one that holds his heart. But he know he can't be with LaKenya because he messed up with her. And LaKenya know Chris ain't ish. So he know not to pursue her because he know LaKenya know, he knows LaKenya ain't fooling with him. But out of all the kids, I feel like the twin boys is what holds his heart. I don't think he ever really cared for Jasmine's kids because he never really cared for her. He just dealt with Jasmine, but he wasn't. Yeah, it's unfortunate to say, but he wasn't. He wasn't really studying that girl. You know, Ronnie Rivers, I don't know why Philip loves Hannah. I have, you know, because y'all remember Philip and Hannah didn't just meet a year ago. They've been known each other. They knew each other from back in the day when Hannah was a teenager. And Philip really shouldn't have been dealing with, because I think Philip is a few years older than Hannah. So, and that's another thing. We found out when Hannah and Philip went on their trip, I think it was a Valentine's Day trip, and they did a Q&A. We found out then that, hell, Philip was creeping with Hannah when he was messing with Jasmine. We found that out. That's why I couldn't understand, not saying that Jasmine should hold resentment towards Hannah, but sis, I mean, I don't know. We wouldn't have been Ace Boon Coon. We would have been cordial because my kids got to come over there where you live at. But baby, we wouldn't have been. I wouldn't have been calling you up talking about, can you watch? Can you go to Aiden's field trip with? Nah. You don't know what Hannah see in Philip. Well, you know what? We would have to see what Hannah's previous boyfriends look like. And then we probably can understand why what she sees in Philip. We don't know what the men that she dated prior to Philip. Because I don't care what nobody say. Hannah is a college graduate. She's a sorority sister. She's traveled many places. And the girl, the fact that you landed with a man with 10 kids, baby, is... It just behooves me. Philip is a manipulator. Yeah, that's how he was able to be a pimp. You would have to be a master manipulator to be a pimp. He said, I don't understand how anyone can deal with him. I don't know how she brought him home and told her mama. Well, I'ma just say this. Hannah mama really love her. Okay, I'ma just say that. Hannah mama really love her. Child Philip ain't even cute. Them big old bug eyes. Nisha said, Hannah is slow. She with a man with 10 kids who is clearly still messing around on her and with younger women. What Nisha, I feel like Philip is a big flirt. And he'll flirt with a chick in front of Hannah's face and behind her back. Like he that type. Anytime that Philip had Jasmine babysitting Asia's kids while he took Asia out, you know, to work. Wink, wink, or to work, and had Jasmine in there babysitting Asia's kids, baby. That you, right? Nearly exactly, sis. Jazz wanted to get rid of the children, so she didn't care. Hey, Newton. Yeah, we did. No, he not PRB. That man, hey, baby, ain't nothing about him cute. Not even the way he walked. Some women like men that have reinvent and help. Kiara said, I would have thought Hannah would have left after the most recent situation with the young girl. Yeah, Kiara, you would have thought so. But, you know, like we just discussed, Philip is definitely a master manipulator, okay? Not see it from Ice Age. Y'all be a mess. Y'all are a mess. See, y'all, what's going on with Chrissy over there? I haven't seen her upload in quite some time. Remember, Tasha Phil convinced Jasmine he was doing studies, and she believed him. She still believes him to this day. Jasmine still believes to this day that Philip was out doing studies and he was actually doing other women. He was studying all right. He was studying all right. You think so, Simply D? She started a new channel with her kids. Oh, Chrissy did? You said Chrissy in Miami. Living like she don't have kids. Girl, shut up. No, she ain't in Miami. Who watching all them children? Baby, I never seen nothing. You said Chrissy still Chrissy in? She was on vacation. Well, when do the kids go on vacation? Baby, I ain't never seen nothing like it. I'm sure it's obviously cheap to take you. And I definitely, it's expensive to take the other kids, but I don't understand why the kids can't never go anywhere. And even as a mother myself, there was very few times that I went somewhere by myself, but there was more times that I took all them kids than I did when me going by myself. I don't understand that. Her said, I definitely agree. Philip is nothing cute to look at, better yet, even want to go have on a chat with. Yeah, I would too, Newton. Always leaving my kids behind. Yeah, it's just strange. Like, okay, Chrissy, we get it, sis, but when do you ever take your kids anywhere? Hell, can you take the kids to a carnival? Chad, ooh. Newton says, I travel a lot for work, and that's hard enough. If I vacation, I prefer to take my kiddos. Exactly, girl. Even when my kids were young and I would take a vacation or, you know, go somewhere for the weekend or something like that, I always felt guilty, and I made sure within the next couple of months, I took them kids somewhere too, because I just felt like, I don't know, I just felt like it was wrong. I don't know why I felt that way, y'all. I just did. I felt like I was wrong. So I said, well, no, I'm going to have to circle back and take these kids somewhere.
Different times here, Mar. Yeah, that's true, sis. Chrissy in Denver, she could have took them kids on a cute ski trip, baby. And you didn't have 9. No, I didn't, sis. I had 4, and that was it. Puh. I knew better because, you know, kids are expensive. And I, in my mind, I didn't want to be raising kids for the next 50 years. You know what I'm saying? Like, eventually, I wanted to be able to, you know, get to the age that I am now and, you know, start living my life as a, you know, kids grown and gone about their business. And obviously, if you need me, I'm right here. But it ain't like I got to make sure you get up and go to school. You got clean clothes. You got your shoes. Yeah, obviously my kids are adults now. They handle that on their own. And Tasha, that's why Gina over there planning family vacation with her kids now, because the people were dragging her for running around with the new white man. She with fetish is black women. He's been on VH1 show. Well, you know, but it's funny that you mentioned that, Vaughn. It's funny you mentioned that, because I said that to a friend the other day, because I got a friend that watched Gina, and we were talking about that. And I said, because I remember her, what did she say? She said Gina's somewhere. She's on another trip somewhere. I said, again? Now, I understand trips is content for her. I said, but girl, when do you ever take those kids? Like, I think Gina takes those kids somewhere, what, once a year? Like, I'm sure you, because Ashton and what's her daughter's name? I can't think of her daughter's name. I think the little boy name is Ashton. And I can't think of the little girl's name. I'm sure you're missing game, because, you know, her two kids, her girl and her boy, they're in sports and things like that. Like, Gina running around here like she 20. Girl, you damn near 40. If not, close to 40. I just don't understand, like, all them. And then y'all keep going to the same places. Like, how many times are we going to go to St. Martin? And like, y'all keep going to the same places. Like, my thing is, shit, you been there once, you been there. Hey, furry. Ethan and Ashton, that's what it is. Tasha, she just got back again. They drug her for not having her oldest son, Byron, in the clips. Ethan is the son and Ashton is the daughter. Okay, thank you. Okay, y'all. Y'all know, I'm sorry, y'all. I was watching Gina at first a few years ago, like around the pandemic, mid-pandemic. And then over time, I was just like, I don't know. The fact that Gina is obviously making really good money on social media, and the fact that you won't buy a house, which I'm not saying I'm not mad at Gina, but I just feel like, you're spending all this money, like, it just seems very irresponsible, you know? Like, I'm hoping and praying that in the event that Gina leaves, when she leaves this earth, that you got some type of life insurance policy, some for these kids. Like, girl, if you ain't got health insurance, I'ma just assume you ain't got no life insurance policy. You said my boys have been everywhere with me, but not this time. I'm going to Jamaica without them. And rightfully so, Black and Bougie, because your boys are older. You know what I'm saying? Your boys are older now. And hell, to be quite honest with you, they probably don't want to go to Jamaica with you. You know what I'm saying? They probably say, nah, mama, we cool. Just leave us some money here and we'll see you when you get back. He never takes her to his home. He always comes to hers, or they meet up.
which is very strange to me. Yeah, you're talking about Gina Janine. Yeah, that's true. I seen that. I don't know. Gina needs to sit down. She acting like she's nothing like the people that she hang out with. She's very different to me. It seems like Gina is trying to relive her young days. Well, sis, you kicking 40 in the ass if she not already 40. Like Gina, what is Gina? What is she? Her late 30s? She said the kids have basketball, so they can't travel as much as her. She's 41? Is she? Oh, okay. Well, again, I'm not saying that Gina needs to act like an old lady, but I feel like at some point those trips, she needs to be a little bit more, I don't know. I just feel like it's very irresponsible constantly going on. Because at this point, I don't never see her like promoting any brand deals with these trips or anything. I'm pretty sure she's spending more money than she's earning back. One moment, you guys. All right, you guys, I'm sorry about that. Okay, she's 42. She's renting a brand new house, spent almost $50,000 on a professional interior designer, got a Range Rover and a brand new Maybach, and said she won't buy because she doesn't want to pay homeowner fees. You don't want to pay homeowner fees, but I'm sure you're paying high-ass insurance for a Range Rover and a Maybach. You know, I guess they would make money, Black and Bougie, as far as putting the video, the content on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? So I guess they, I mean, obviously they're making money because the videos get views. But y'all know taking trips, you know, that's, I don't know. It just, you know, again, this is social media, okay? And your money is not guaranteed. It's predicated on what the people are willing to watch and willing to view. And over time, like how many times can you watch people go to Mexico? Like you can only watch that so many times. How many times are you going to watch somebody go to wherever they, you know, all these other countries, that Dubai and all that, especially if you're watching other people who are doing the same thing. Like if I watch one person go to Mexico, I'm not going to watch four other YouTubers to go to the same damn country. And more than likely, because most times they're everybody going to the same cities in Mexico, Tulum and, you know, and all them other, like how many times you going to watch that? I don't know. That's just my opinion, y'all. Maybe I'm just weird like that. The Mr. CJ too. Hey, how are you? At Tamri, they drug her for that. Why spend money on the interior designer when it's not even your house? Yeah, I didn't know that. Like I said, y'all, I don't really watch Gina Janine like that. So I didn't know she spent $50,000 on an interior designer for a rental home. Baby, that's nasty work right there. That's insane. $50,000 for a rental home? Child, please. I wouldn't want my miss my kids' events either. And Gina misses a lot of them as if they don't mean anything. And I bet you any type of money, those kids are noticing that. Just like they look in the stands and they see their teammates, moms, dads, grandmothers, aunts, uncles, and whomever. And every time they look in the stands, their mother is never there, or she's rarely there. But dad is always showing up. Trust and believe, those kids are going to remember that. They're gonna watch your videos and seeing where you was drinking and having a good time while they were trying to, you know, win the championship game. But you thought it was more important to go drink with some people you don't even know versus sitting there rooting your children on. I don't know, y'all. It's just strange behavior to me. But okay, y'all, that's my time. Let me get on up off of here. I just wanted to come and give y'all a couple of my thoughts that I was thinking about. And then obviously we changed the subject, and that's okay. We can definitely change the subject. I don't know, y'all. I just really feel like these people are weird on this internet. And you know what? I don't know. It's just weird to me how a lot of these people carry on. You know, when my mom passed away, it just really made me rethink a lot of things, you know? It just really made me rethink a lot of things. And we all know that we're not promised, and everybody has their expiration date on this earth. And I'm not saying live your life to the fullest, but the one thing that's most important and very near and dear is your time with your children. You can't never get that time back. You can never get it back. I've had many days of thinking about my memories with my mom here recently since she's been gone. And I thank God I have all those memories. I'm talking about from when I was a child to most recently. And I thank God I have those imagine not having those thoughts of spending time with your parents and with your family, you know? I don't know. It's sad, you guys, but it's the world we live in. Good luck to these folks, honey. Good luck to them, okay? One thing I can say, my kids can definitely say, if they don't say anything else, they have good memories. And they have good memories of my mom, because my mom took them on many vacations without me. She took her grandkids by themselves, you know, just her and her grandkids went on many vacations. And when my mom passed, you know, they talked about those things. They was like, Mom, I remember when Nana took us here and Nana took us there. Like they have those memories. And that was very important. And my mother did that for a reason, because she wanted her grandkids to remember her. And that they do, you know. So I don't get these chicks. I don't get Jasmine. I don't get Chrissy. I don't get Olivia. Olivia's another one. Girl, you ain't never took your kids nowhere. You hooping and hollering because Gerard won't pick up the phone or he won't let you talk to kids. Girl, take your kids somewhere. Plan a vacation for your children this summer. Give them some memories. Don't only give them the memory of you dragging a daddy on the internet. Take your kids somewhere. Like, since you might not get a chance to do, I mean, you know, we don't know. We don't know what's going on, when we're going to leave this earth. We just don't know. I don't know, y'all. Memories are definitely very important. All right, y'all, I'm gone. I'm out of here. Y'all be good. Y'all be great. TM, I'm going to see y'all in the next one, honey. Remember, sub what you love. Bye.